Okay, the recording is started right now. I'm going to make a review about your third assignment. Mana sih meeting? About your third assignment, pertemuan ketiga. Remember? I asked you to make an assessment, self-assessment. How do you feel when you making that assignment? Volunteer boleh?
Excited me.
Excited. Siapa itu?
Excited.
Kalau misalnya when you want to answer my questions, please say your name. Ardinda Mias. Ini. Karena di sini layar saya kan penuh.
Ardinda Mias. Excited.
Yeah. Excited. Did you get something? Dapat sesuatu when you make that assignment? Ada nilainya enggak?
Yes.
Oke, okay, seperti apa?
Like introspeksi, Miss.
Introspeksi. Oke, okay, Ardinda, thank you. How about you, Mr. Kain? Did you gain something when you making that self-assessment? Did you realize something? Oh, sepertinya ternyata saya teh pinter gitu kan? Pak KM, gimana? How do you feel? Senyum wae, Pak KM mah. Tetap harus menjawab, dah.
Gimana, Miss?
How do you feel when you make self-assessment? Bagaimana rasanya?
Confused.
Confused.
About weakness and apa? Strength. Kelemahan, kelemahan.
Kelemahan. Are you confused about your weakness?
Yes.
Okay. So you didn't realize that you had weakness. Kamu nggak tahu kelemahan kamu apa aja?
No, I don't.
Okay.
I don't.
Jadi, so you know about your strength. Kamu tahu yes, kelebihan kamu apa aja kan?
Yes, I know.
Yeah, so you know about your strength, but you didn't know about your weakness.
But I don't know about weakness.
Okay, weakness itu contohnya for siapa yang mau kasih contoh buat weakness? Contohnya boleh? Ada yang mau kasih tahu? Weakness? Apa yang kalian tulis untuk weakness-nya? Muhammad Iqbal boleh? Siapa baca? Peggy, bentar ya Peggy ya. Peggy, Ardinda, abis Muhammad Iqbal ya. Oke, okay, Muhammad Iqbal, can you tell Gofar or ask about your weaknesses? Kelemahan kamu apa aja?
Saya, Miss?
Iya, atuh. Ada Muhammad Iqbal lain lagi nggak?
My weakness is maybe apa ya? Yeah, bad management at time.
Uh-uh.
And a little bit negative thinking.
Negative thinking. So you know about your weakness. How can you try to overcome? Bagaimana cara kamu mengatasi kelemahan itu? Kira-kira ada gambaran nggak?
Learning management principle.
Learning. Wah, sick. Mantap. Auto A kamu. Terus?
A.
Pasti dapat A. Sok, jawab lagi. Terus apa lagi?
That's enough. I think yes.
Oh, cukup. That's udah dapat A, udah cukup, Miss. Oke, okay, baiklah Ardinda and then Peggy, you're next. Ardinda, is it you want to answer? Ya. Yeah?
Yes. Me first?
Yes, please.
Miss?
Yeah, please.
My weakness is I cry very easily, and I have a sensitive heart.
Uh-huh.
When I see person,
uh-huh.
Like kasihan gitu, misalnya.
You feel pity.
And then, Yes, sometimes people say it not sad, but I cry. So, and then I also like to have a mood that goes up and down. Like sometimes I'm lazy, or sometimes I'm so excited, and then I'm not good at English, but I will try my best.
Okay, thank you, Ardinda. How about you, Peggy?
My weakness is forgetful, and then careless. But I try schedule everything to always remember it, miss.
Okay, thank you. Jadi seperti itu, Gofar. Jadi weaknesses itu kelemahan tuh bukan berarti kelemahan tuh kekurangan ya. Kelemahan means you have to make something to fix your problems, the cause of your problem. Contohnya gini, misalnya ya, kamu itu telat ke sekolah. Kenapa? Telat berangkat ke kampus atau telat online sekarang ini? Kenapa? Because you wake up too late. Kamu bangunnya terlambat. Berarti kamu ada masalah dengan time schedule, kan? Tidurnya terlambat. Seperti itu. Itu kelemahan. Bukan berarti kelemahan itu kekurangan. Tapi sesuatu yang kamu harus, you have to work on it. Kamu harus melakukan sesuatu untuk memperbaikinya. To fix it. Seperti itu. Ya. Kemudian apalagi kelemahan itu? Kelemahan itu bisa kurang pandai memanage waktu. Bisa juga kelemahan itu not confidence, nggak percaya diri. Sebentar.
Nanti keluar aja dulu. Oke, bye-bye.
Ya, asistennya saya keluarin dulu. Nah, jadi weaknesses itu seperti itu. Jadi ada beberapa hal yang you have to work on it to make it better. If you work on your weaknesses, it's going to make you a better person. Jadi kamu kalau memperbaiki kekurangan kamu itu, kamu bisa menjadi orang yang lebih baik lagi. Insya Allah, of course, ya. Seperti itu. Ada lagi? How about your dreams, your futures? Ada yang mau share? Andi Suhandi, boleh? Pika, Andi Suhandi. Berikutnya, Pika boleh?
I like to rush to do something.
Oh, terlalu terburu-buru melakukan sesuatu ya?
Yeah.
Okay. How about your the questions number five? Questions number five. I'm asking you about your dreams and about your futures. Do you make a plans about your futures? What you want to become in the futures? Andi Suhandi, mau jadi apa cita-citanya?
Tentara.
Mau jadi tentara, oke. Nanti after graduated from LP3I, mungkin kamu bisa melanjutkan pendidikan sebelum kamu masuk menjadi tentara. Ada lagi yang lain?
Ambilan suara.
Boleh. Adit berikutnya ya. Ya, tadi Anit. Ya, oke, okay, Anita.
For me, after graduating from LPTBI, I will work in one company. I will experience there as well as rise my...
Oke, Rinky nanti ya.
Because I don't want to always rely on other people.
Okay, Nabila, thank you.
I want to open a new job. I do.
You want to open a job for your friends, for another people, yeah? You want to become entrepreneur, pengusaha?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mau jadi pengusaha, Nabila? Betul. Unmute dulu atuh mic-nya kalau ngomong, Neneng.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, thank you. Kamu gerak-gerak, saya nggak dengar.
Yes, miss.
Okay, thank you. Tadi Adit, kemudian Rifki ya? Tadi yang... Ya, okay, please.
Yes, miss.
Okay, gimana tadi?
I want...
Iya, tadi Adit mau jadi apa? What you want to become in the future?
I want to become education minister.
Oh, menteri pendidikan. Boleh, boleh. Insya Allah. Nanti kalau sudah jadi menteri pendidikan, jangan lupa sama saya ya. Thank you, Adit. How about you, Rifki Nova?
I think I have many goals and dreams for the next few years. I want to be an entrepreneur and develop many enterprises. I also want to be an influencer and useful content creator. And I want to be a motivator for young children. Mm-hmm. And most important, I want to be a self-help, a person who grows up every day as a devout Muslim and as a leader who can be a good example to many people, especially to my family.
Okay, you want to become a role model yang menjadi contoh bagi semua orang ya. Is that all right, Rifki? Is that true, Rifki?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, miss.
Yeah, Fika. Fika tadi raise hand juga ya.
Want to be a housewife and become a lecturer.
Housewife and?
And become a lecturer.
Become a lecturer. Mau jadi kayak saya? Jangan, nggak enak. Jadi dosen yeah. mah, jangan, nggak enak. Ngadepin mahasiswa kayak begini, aku pusing. Oke, Putri. Putri mau apa? Thank you, Vika. Putri and then Siti.
In the most important, I will make my parents happy and I want to be a system analysis.
Wow, system analysis. Wah, it's a heavy for me. Heavy topic. I want to ask you. Nggak akan nanya saya. Sistem analisis mah pusing artinya. Amelia, Gofar, kemudian siapa lagi ini yang recent tadi? Amelia, Gofar, Haila ya, sama Siti. Siti boleh Siti duluan, kemudian Amelia, Gofar, sama Haila ya, in order urutannya begitu. Kemudian Nusari dan Amita. Oke?
Okay? Aku dulu miss.
Aku teh yang mana sebentar?
Siti Lipoya.
Iya, Siti. Abis Siti, abis Siti tadi siapa? Amelia, Haila, Gofar. Terus siapa lagi? Nur Sarika sama Dina. Ingat-ingat ya, saya lupa soalnya. Dah, Puput, kemudian Amita. Sop.
Bentar, Miss. My friend, for the future, I must be a better student. Active in campus activist, BF successful person in the world and the afterlife.
In the afterlife ya, dunia akhirat jadinya ya. Oke, okay. Thank you. Suksesnya atau dunia akhirat, nggak dunia doang ya?
Iya.
Oke, okay. Thank you. Tadi berikutnya siapa ya? Saya lupa.
Amelia, Miss.
Amelia, boleh.
A plan for the future, having success. Tech and employ other people to reach unemployment in Indonesia.
Wis, mantap. Thank you, Amelia. Haila ya? Abis Haila, Gofar.
Yeah, Miss. My goals, I will improve many things and the most important thing is the goal of the future plan, which is financial freedom in order to help more people who are struggling in the economy.
Okay, you want to become financial free so you can help many people, ya? Yeah? Jadi orang kaya, jadi bisa sawer gitu kan? Asik banget tuh bisa berbagi sharing. Okay, Gofar, how about you?
I always that in the future I could become an accountant in government or audit government. And so going to college now, maybe able to help my dreams and able my effort to achieve what I'm planning.
Okay, so you want to become an accountant, that's why you are here in LP3I, di Prodi Akuntansi, gitu? Okay, thank you, Gofar. Next, siapa tadi? Saya lupa. Tadi urutannya gimana? Nusarika ya? Nusarika, Puput, Amita, Haila udah kan ya? Belum?
Dina, Bu.
Oh, Dina. Boleh, Dina. Boleh.
Nesarika dulu, mau Dina dulu.
Boleh, siapa dulu? Dina yang udah on mic, gak apa-apa. Habis itu Nesarika ya.
Yeah. I want to continue studying and at the same time work as an accountant. Mm-hmm. And I want to teach. I want to teach. Okay.
You want to become a teacher?
Yes.
It's much difficult than Vika's dream becoming a lecturer. Jadi teacher, apalagi kindergarten teacher. Oh my god, pulang-pulang kamu minum obat sakit kepala every day.
Doain aja Bu.
Insya Allah lancar semuanya ya.
Amin.
Oke, okay, next Nesarika.
My dream is that I want to become a religious teacher.
Guru agama, oke. Okay. Thank you Nesarika. Berikutnya siapa tadi? Amita ya? Amita, Puput, Farhan. Itu urutannya? Boleh?
Yes, Miss.
Amita, Puput, Farhan, Muhammad, Silvi, sama Nurul ya. Tolong diingat-ingat ya. Oke. Okay. Amita, please.
I want to be useful human being for others, Miss.
Become apa?
I want to be useful human being for others.
Maksudnya apa tuh? Suaranya agak putus-putus.
Jadi orang yang berguna bagi orang lain, Miss.
Becoming a useful person for others, ya? Itu yang yes. paling penting. Kamu pintar nggak ada gunanya if you're not making some contributions to the persons around you. Abis ini siapa?
Yes, yes.
Thank you. Abis itu Amita tadi siapa ya? Saya lupa.
Ardiansah, Miss.
Yes. Ardiansah gitu?
Puput, Miss.
Puput, Puput dulu. Oke, okay, Puput terus Farhan ya? Ya, Puput terus Farhan.
A person who is useful for himself, his family and other. Okay. And a public speaking, and a motivator, and accountant, and successful in this world and the hereafter.
Oh, jadi akuntan, public speaking, motivator, sukses dunia akhirat. Amin. Farhan, kemudian Nurul ya. Farhan, Nurul, Ardiansyah, Lutfi, Farhah, Muhammad siapa ini? Muhammad yang lagi ngelamun, Muhammad Ivan, baru Salsabil. Oke, urutannya diingat-ingat. Farhan.
Yes, sir. Yes, miss. I want to be an entrepreneur and of course also went to work in the military to make my parents happy.
Okay, so your parents want you to become soldiers, mau jadi tentara gitu ya?
Yes.
Okay, insya Allah kabul ya. You can fulfill your parents' dream ya. Kemudian tadi siapa saya lupa? Nurul.
My future plan is I want to become an entrepreneur and live in the world of entertainment.
Okay, want to become entrepreneur. Abis ini, thank you Nurul. Abis ini siapa tadi? Muhammad, Farhah ya? Farhan udah kan?
Sudah, Miss.
Oke, okay, Farhah berarti sama Muhammad, Ivan. Kemudian Ardiansyah ya?
Yes, Miss.
Nurul udah belum? Nurul udah, oke. Okay. Sok, silahkan.
Yes.
My dream is I want to work in dream office like a Shopee office.
Oh, mau kerja di Shopee. Oke. Okay. Yes. Shopee paket every day ya. Huh? Oke, okay, thank you Muhammad Ifar.
Yes, Miss.
Ya, yeah, kamu you raise your hands?
Yes.
Oke.
Okay. My plan for the future is to live I'm meaningful and useful live for other. I will be a successful son. Please, I have to make my parents proud, continue to be fair and raise the status of parents.
Okay, this you want to raise your families, yeah.
I went to have a career from the country or serve the country and region. The three plan, I want to continue to learn to change my knowledge and practice my knowledge.
Okay, you want a higher education, saya mau dapat pendidikan lebih tinggi lagi ya?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Ardiansa, Salsabil, Daniel, Ardinda, Risha, Alia, Widya. Oh, Lutfi kelewat ya? Okay, Ardiansyah dulu boleh? Abis Ardiansyah, Lutfi.
Yes, miss.
Okay.
My dreams, our goal, is to become an officer. And be able to make my family happy and protect my family and lock my destiny. Because love can make strong people weak and love can make weak people strong.
Masih, mantap itu quotes-nya. Love, 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 ya. Keren. Tapi kamu jangan lupa, kamu submit tugasnya dalam bentuk Word. Harus diganti dalam bentuk PDF. Saya jadi ingat karena saya melihat namamu. Nanti tugas ketiga disubmit lagi ya. Oke, okay, thank you Ardiansa. Lutfi.
I aspire to be a head manager in company, more especially a financial manager, miss.
Oh, manager keuangan. Keren, yes, yes. Tanggung jawabnya besar. It's a big responsibility. Salsa Bills and Daniel.
Yes, miss, but before, sorry, Salsa of them because I have problem with my connects.
It's all right, as long as you can answer my questions, yeah?
Okay. My plans for the future when I graduate from LP3I, I want to get a job according to my interest and my talent. I want to work in order to raise capital to build my own business so that when my business has run smoothly, I can work from home and become a freelancer.
Okay. What is your talent and your interest?
In bagian administrasi gitu, Min. Miss.
Oh, administrations ya. Oke, okay. Jadi yeah. Kamu anak AB ya?
Iya. Yeah.
Baiklah. Besar kemungkinan kamu akan bertemu saya lagi in the future. Oke, okay. Daniel. Okay. Daniel and Ardina nanti.
I want to make my parents happy and I want to be a businessman and I want see Blackpink.
Asik, become a businessman ya, make your parents happy ya. Oke, okay, Ardinda. Thank you, Daniel. Ardinda.
Hello, miss.
Yeah.
For the first time, I will say thank you so much for the question. Mm-hmm. And then, my goal is become a doctor, but it's so difficult. Uh-huh. And then that's my goal after I'm completing my D3 education. Uh-huh. And then I have their own business shop, sell for use kinds of skincare and K-pop stuff. I want to continue my education abroad, especially in Korea. And then make an effort for both my parents. I have a job. My parents can be proud of me.
Okay, can't you see my smile is bigger?
I also really want.
You also? Pardon?
Yes, miss.
Yeah, terusin nggak apa-apa. Sorry.
Okay. Okay. I also really want to make a psychologist house for the children or teenager, and I hope that all of my goals is our achievement. Thank you, miss.
Okay, I want to save your number because you want to sell a skincare product. Yeah, saya save nomor kamu nanti. Okay, I want to become your customers.
Okay, miss.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, miss.
Okay, Widya, Sylvie, Risha, and Wilda. Mau jadi apa?
Psikologis.
Psikolog.
Ya. Yeah.
Oke, okay, nggak apa-apa. Nanti berarti kamu you have to continue your studies ya, right after you get your diploma degrees ya. Nerusin kuliah lagi berarti kalau jadi psikolog ya. Jangan becoming success person, but maybe I will not go to your psychological practice becoming your patient. Ya, saya nggak mau jadi pasien kamu nanti. Berarti I'm not in the right mind. Tapi sometimes people get mislead understanding, memiliki persepsi yang salah tentang orang pergi ke psikologi itu sebagai orang yang memiliki kelainan jiwa. Padahal banyak cara yang bisa mereka dapatkan dari konsultasi dengan seorang psikolog, ya. Bukan cuman dari bukan berarti dicap maaf dalam artian gila atau enggak waras, tapi banyak hal yang bisa kalian dapatkan dengan konsultasi dengan psikolog. Jadi pada saat you need something or you need a person to talk to, kamu bisa get help from the psychologist, dari psikolog itu, ya. Okay, thank you Widya, success with your dreams, ya. Nanti saya akan simpan kartu nama kamu, maybe. Saya butuh nanti buat kalau misalnya ada orang yang, oh mau jadi apa nanti you in the future, konsultasi sama Widya, okay? Thank you. Sylvie and Risha, kemudian Wilda.
Okay, Miss. I want to have my own successful company, Miss.
Oh, mau punya perusahaan, what kind of company?
Yes.
What kind of company? Perusahaan apa?
Perusahaan ini, Bu.
Harus jelas kan mau punya perusahaan, tapi nggak jelas perusahaan ini mana bisa diaminin doanya.
Bisnis, Bu.
Bisnis apa?
Semacam apa ya, Bu?
Kayak Ardinda, udah yakin mau jual skincare, saya udah langsung daftar jadi pelanggan, kan kayak gitu. Oke, okay, bisnisnya dipikirin dulu. Kita tanya ke Risha sama Wilda nanti. Risha?
Yeah, Miss. My goal is to be a businesswoman at his own expense or to continue in a parent business so then I can buy things without price.
Okay, what kind of business that your parent have? Punya usaha apa maksudnya?
Usaha makanan gitu, kayak kuliner.
Oke, okay. Makanan apa?
Khas Bandung gitu.
Asik. Timbel?
Apa ya? Sale pisang, Miss.
Oh, asik. Boleh nanti saya belanja di situ, ya. Oke, okay. Thank you. Wilda?
Yes, Miss.
Ya?
Yeah. My future plan is to pursue make my parents happy, myself, get a job in the position I want. I have my own business, open up job for people.
Oke, okay. What kind of positions that you want? Mau posisi apa kamu?
Manager.
Manager bagian apa? Your dream have to be specific, you know, for you to achieve it.
Inginnya sih bagian keuangan.
Amin, insya Allah. Sylvie udah ketemu bisnisnya mau apa? Bisnisnya mau apa tadi, Sylvie?
Well, Bu.
Wedding organizer. Nggak mungkin saya daftar. Yeah. Paling buat daftar wedding anak saya, ya. Not from my own wedding, okay? I already married, yes, and have two children. Okay, thank you. Do you know why I asked you about your dreams, your futures? Because our topic for today is about mission, visions, and values. Okay, what is values? What is mission, visions? You heard about it? Have you ever heard about visions or missions? Pernah dengar kan visi? Visi kami adalah, misi kami adalah calon-calon ini. Do you know the difference? Do you know the difference between vision and mission? Yes, Dina. The difference between vision and mission.
Mission is the goal or target of a company in the short term. Vision is the ideal or perspective of the company in the long term future.
Okay, perspective for long and mission is a short. Close, yes, ya. Oke, okay, tadi siapa lagi yang raise hand?
Me.
Siapa Mi teh?
Peggy.
Oke. Okay. Abis Peggy, Gofar. Oke, okay, gimana?
In my opinion, a mission statement defines the company's business, is its objectives, and its approach to reach those objectives. And then, vision is, I forget, Miss. Vision is a statement describes the desired future position of the company.
Okay, thank you, Peggy. How about you, Gofar?
I think vision is a dream or goal of a company. And vision is something that must be done to realize that dream or goal. Jadi visi itu tujuan yang dibuat oleh suatu perusahaan, sedangkan misinya itu apa yang harus dilakukan oleh perusahaan demi mencapai tujuan itu, Bu.
Yes, that's right. Apa yang Gofar katakan, pantas kamu jadi KM ya, punya visi dan misi. Okay, good answer. So, why I ask you about your dreams? Because your dreams is your visions. Yeah, what you want to become in the future. That's visions. What the company wants to become in the future. What is the goals for in the long term for the company? That's visions. How about the missions? The missions is a breakdown from a visions. Just like Gofar said, something you have to do in order to fulfilling the visions, to fulfilling your dreams. For example, yeah, you want to become an entrepreneur, you want to become a manager in accountants, you want to become a lecturer, you want to become a teacher. That's your visions. But your missions is you have to do something in order to fulfilling your dreams, to achieve your dreams. Yeah, one missions that you have to complete in 3 years is to get graduated from LT3GI. Yeah, that the analogical ways to explain about visions and missions. Yeah, so your dreams is your visions, and your missions right now is to graduate from LT3GI. Your missions is how can you going on the right way to achieving your dreams. Bisa dimengerti? Okay, thank you. I want to share a videos with you. Ya, kita tonton dulu.
Forward this link on to friends. And today I wanted to share with you the importance of having a vision, a mission, values, a purpose, a message, and sprinkling some goals throughout that along the way. Now, I don't know about you, but I certainly come across lots of people out there that have certain moments in their life, troughs for want of a better phrase, where they struggle with meaning, they struggle with why they're meant to be doing what they're doing, they struggle with why are they going to work, they struggle with why are they doing these tasks day in, day out. They struggle with trying to find, is there really any purpose for life whatsoever? And in doing so, they often struggle to find what it is they want to dedicate their life to. Now, if you ever had a moment or an experience like that, then this content is certainly for you. And if you haven't, then I'm sure you're going to enjoy it.
Okay, jadi dia bilang bahwa banyak orang yang struggling dengan menentukan mereka mau jadi apa. Mereka mau apa yang ingin mereka capai, what they want to become in the future. That's why tadi saya, I asked Sylvie, Sylvie wants to have a business. Saya tanya in detail, saya, what kind of business? Because when you make your visions, you have to get your visions, you can see your visions in a clear. Jadi kamu tahu kamu mau jadi apa itu clear and then jelas banget. Kemudian juga kamu bisa mendeskripsikan, you can describe it. Saya mau buka usaha ini. Harus sejelas itu visi kamu, ya. Oke, kita continue.
Anyway, Now, certainly I've gone through my struggles in my life, and one of them was going through a severe bout of depression that led to quite a lot of debt, being quite overweight, and certainly being unemployed for an extensive period of time. And during that time, I was lucky to have a mentor come up to me and show me what's actually drawn on this board. Now, I'm going to go through what's on this board, but the purpose of me actually explaining it to you is once I was shown this diagram, it gave so much clarity, so much certainty, and so much more of an understanding of how all of these concepts fit together that we hear bandied around so much throughout all the different industries wanting to do self-development or self-help or self-improvement, and certainly wanting to become a leader in your own right. But after I show you this, really what I'd like you to do is think a little bit more than a leader. I want you to think like a visionary leader, because that's really the type of leadership that you want to be allowing yourself to surrender into. So let's get right into the content. Now, if you have a look on the board here, what we're actually looking at is a diagram. And here's the thing, I'm not an artist. I don't get paid to be an artist. So I'm certainly, this is not the best rendition of this diagram I could ever draw. But the fact is, this diagram represents some very, very critical information that I want you to take some notes on. So here's what you need to do. First of all, if we have a look at the diagram, here's how it all fits together. If we can imagine that this is actually a path that you're walking along. So this is the path you're going to be journeying through for your life. Now, this path, it represents what one might call their mission. As in,
okay, lihat jalan ini. Tadi dia bilang jalan ini sebagai apanya? Jalan ini apa ini? Kedengaran nggak?
Mission, Bu.
Mission. This is your path along the way. Jadi ini adalah missions, ya?
And how they're going to get to where they want to get to. You'll notice that this path leads all the way up to a big red sun. Now this sun represents your vision. So if we
okay. How about this big red sun? What is it?
Vision.
Vision. Visions, your dreams, your futures, ya. Yeah? So this path, jalan ini menuju ke mimpi. Okay.
Just start with the understanding that first of all, our mission is going to take us up to our vision. And you can draw this diagram out as I'm talking along with you. Now you notice down the bottom here, there's a question mark. And this question mark resembles your purpose in life. As in, why is it that you're actually going to get on this journey to begin with? Why is it you're going to step on this path, walk all the
question marks ini, kenapa kamu mau mulai jalan ini? Why you choose your dreams? Why you choose your missions? Why you are here right now in this classroom? This is the question marks, ya. Yeah? What do you want to achieve? Jadi sini, kamu mau mencapai apa? Kamu mau jadi apa? Kamu ada di posisi ini kenapa? That's the questions, ya.
Yeah? Way up and eventually get to your vision in life. So I guess the purpose becomes the why we do what we do. The mission becomes the how we are going to do what we do. And the vision becomes the what we're actually going to create as a result of that. Now you'll notice down here, we've got a little thing that looks not unlike a compass. Again, not my best drawing to date, but you get the idea. Down here, we do have a compass. And this compass resembles our values in life, as in that which we deem to be most important at any given time. And the reason we like to resemble or represent your values as a compass is because your values let you know at any given time whether or not you're on path or off. In fact, your values are those things that when you are doing and living and experiencing them from day in, day out, you're feeling those feelings.
Okay, how about the compass? What is the symbol? Kompasnya itu mewakili apa?
The values.
Values. What is values? What is the values? Apa itu nilai-nilai? Perasaan kamu pada saat kamu memenuhi sebuah impian, inspirasi kamu, rasa bersyukur kamu, kemudian juga kehadiran kamu, kemudian apa lagi? Keberadaan kalian, terus tadi yang disebut oleh teman kalian, Ardiansyah, certainly of love, ada rasa cinta di situ, ada rasa kehadiran di situ. That's value, ya. Yeah? Perasaan yang kamu dapatkan.
Feelings of fulfillment, of inspiration, of gratitude, of presence, and certainly of love. And that's really how we know that we're on track with where we're going to. So we like to pick up the compass, have a good reason why, get on our path, which is our mission, and start making our way up to our vision. Now, here's the thing. You'll notice also that there are some green signposts that are pointing in certain directions along your path. Now, these green signposts actually represent your goals in life. So people often have a misunderstanding about what goals really are. They set these goals, which they basically just want to go and achieve the thing. Like, I want to get to 77 kilos and 13% body fat. But when they get there, they stop doing whatever they were doing, and all of a sudden they go back on the yo-yoing system. They pretty soon start gaining weight only to set a new goal of getting back to 77 kilos. So people don't...
Yang hijau-hijau ini apa? The green signs?
Goals.
Goals. Jadi kamu ngerti sekarang ya kenapa goals itu different from missions and visions. Because goals is a little achievement that you get when you want to fulfilling your dreams. Jadi pencapaian-pencapaian kecil. Sometimes people think that when they're achieving their goals or they're fulfilling their goals, they stop. Their life is stuck right there. So the people don't really understand that goals in and of themselves is not to be all and all. Jadi goals itu bukan akhir atau bukan selesai sampai di situ. Bisa dimengerti? When you achieving certain goals, tujuan tertentu, then you have to creating a new goals. Kalau kamu udah mencapai satu, one steps fulfilling your goals, and then you have to make a new goals. Example ya, you are graduated from preschool, TK. And then after preschool, you are entering elementary school, sekolah dasar kan? You fulfilling your elementary school for 6 years ya, 6 tahun ya, SD. 6 tahun di SD lulus, terus setelah lulus SD kamu joget-joget, okay, lulus SD gitu. Selesai tugasnya. Enggak kan? Karena setelah lulus SD, you want to set up new target. Apa target barunya? Masuk SMP, lulus dari SMP. Lulus SMP selesai, masuk lagi ke SMA, lulus dari SMA. Udah selesai? Ternyata belum juga. Dari SMA kamu mau, you want to make a better version of yourself. Kamu mau menjadi diri kamu yang lebih baik lagi. So you upgrading your education. Kalian upgrading your education. Apalagi going into a college. Masuk ke sekolah perguruan tinggi, ya. Jadi goals itu not the end of something, but it's a beginning of a new goals, ya.
I really understand that goals in and of themselves are not the be all and end all. Goals are simply signposts to let you know that you are progressing in the right direction. So when you're setting your goals, make sure that they are progress pillars. They are not the final destination. Because a lot of people who achieve their goals often find a sense of depression coming in straight after that because the goals are not linked in a meaningful way to their ultimate vision. So just to go over it once again, we're going to get a reason for why we're going to walk on the path. We're going to grab our compass, which is our values. We're going to allow our values to let us know that we are in fact on path. As we pass the signposts, which are our goals, they will give us a good indication, a good feedback loop to let us know that we are progressing in the right direction. The path is what we know as our mission, as in how we're going to do what we're actually going to be doing. And this path ultimately is going to lead us to our vision in life, that thing that we hold deep inside our heart that has the most amount of meaning that we'd most like to dedicate our life to creating. Now, if you notice here, you've got a person walking along the path. Someone's already found their visionary leadership qualities. They've found their mission. They've found their meaning in life, and they're off and racing. You'll notice this little voice box coming out of their mouth there. This represents your message. Your message is the thing. If you can imagine this, if you're walking down the street on your mission, you're going towards your vision in life, and you're certainly experiencing fulfillment in every single action because you're living true to your value. If someone was to come up and ask you, hey, what's going on and how you been, what you respond, that one sentence you respond to them about the whole meaning of what it is that you do, that becomes your message in life. Kind of think about it like if you could only tell someone one thing in life about their business, their career, finances, health, partnerships, whatever it is, if you could only tell someone one thing, what is it you would like to tell them? And then just make a list of a few things you'd like to tell.
Okay, this is what we're doing right now. Lihat kan ada chat box-nya di sini, seperti yang dia bilang, sharing something. to another person's kan. This is what we're doing right now. Okay?
In fact, as a little bit of home play as a result of watching this video, what I'd like you to do is I'd like you to make a list of all the short sentences you would like to tell somebody if you could only tell them one sentence. And lo and behold, to start to be moving closer to your message. I'll give you some examples. My message in life is to live your love. So if there's only one thing that I could ever tell you to do, it would be live your love. So if I'm walking down the street on my mission, heading towards my vision, someone bumps into me, and I've only got one thing I can say to them, I'd say live your love. For example, Nike, they would say just do it. I'm sure you're starting to get the understanding. So my advice is go ahead and put down some short sentences and start to try and identify what is your message. So I hope you got value out of it. Remember, if we just go back through it one last time, get clear on your values, know why you're going to do what you do, walk the mission with absolute certainty, use the goalposts as feedback loops. When you meet people on the side of the road, share your message with them and never stop moving towards your ultimate vision in life. And that's really how you have the most fulfilling and inspiring experience of this thing that you and I call life. Now, if you enjoyed the video in any way, shape, or form, please post your comments down below and certainly forward this link on to friends so they can also learn how it all fits together and how they can utilize it in their own life. And until we meet again, share your light, live your love, and do it.
Okay. How about the videos? Is it good? Is it inspiring? Menginspirasi nggak? So you know the difference between vision, missions, and values. Sekarang ngerti kan? Okay, I'm going to ask you questions about value. Apa itu value? Value is your guidance. How you know that you are in the right path doing your missions to fulfilling your visions. Itu value, guidance, panduan. Panduan di mana kamu, panduan about right or wrong, about some things that you have to do and you shouldn't do it, apa yang harus kamu lakukan dan seharusnya tidak kamu lakukan. Itu value. Religions is your value, one of your value. Salah satu value kalian itu adalah nilai-nilai yang kalian anut itu adalah value. Rasa senang when you are achieving something, itu adalah value. Ada gambaran?
Yes, ada, Miss.
Okay. Sekarang kita masuk ke PowerPoint-nya. Saya akan ngejelasin sekilas ya. Developing mission, visions, and values. Learning objective. Understand of the R of missions, visions, and values in the planning process. And then understand how missions and vision fit into POLC's frameworks. And then see how patience and creativity relate to visions. And then incorporate stakeholders' interests. Menyatukan stakeholders' interest, kepentingan. Stakeholders itu in the company, stakeholders itu can be an employee, management, kemudian pemegang saham, kemudian governments, kemudian juga stakeholders-nya itu bisa suppliers, bisa juga konsumen. Kemudian develop organizational missions and vision statements and then apply vision, mission, and value to your personal life. Yeah. This the strategy is how the firms or the company aims to realize its missions and vision. This is the goals and objective. This is the strategy. How can you achieving your goals and objective? And then how can you fulfilling your visions and mission? A goals and objective are the indicators how well a strategy is succeeding. Yeah. A firm with clearly communicated and widely understood and also collectively shared missions and vision have been shown to perform better than those without them. Jadi perusahaan yang mengkomunikasikan visi dan misinya yang bisa dimengerti oleh employees-nya and or for every persons in the companies yang setiap orang di perusahaan itu mengerti visi dan misinya, kemudian mereka sharing kepentingannya bahwa mereka memiliki satu tujuan, mencapai tujuan perusahaan. Artinya perusahaan itu ada kemungkinan besar becoming a successful companies. Ya, sebegitu pentingnya visi dan misi. Bisa dimengerti? This is the difference between missions and vision statement. Missions is communicates the organization reason for being. Mission itu mengkomunikasikan alasan kenapa perusahaan itu ada and how it aims to serve its stakeholders dan bagaimana dia mengarahkan tujuan perusahaannya itu untuk memenuhi kepentingan dari key stakeholders-nya. Key stakeholders-nya itu siapa saja? Pemegang saham, konsumen, kemudian employees-nya. Kemudian often integrated summation of a firm value. Bisa juga mission statement itu adalah integrasi dari kumpulan nilai-nilai yang dianut oleh perusahaan. Kemudian mission statement tends to be longer than vision statement. Misi itu biasanya lebih panjang daripada visi. Ya, visi itu biasanya pendek. Just like Nike. Tahu kan Nike perusahaan sport equipment, perusahaan yang apa namanya? Sepatu, baju, topi Nike.
Yes, Miss.
Logonya
yes,
apa?
Yes, Miss.
Just do it. Betul enggak? Begitu ada orang ngomong just do it dengan checklist, oh you know it's Nike. Sebegitu yes. Pentingnya orang memahami visi dan misi sebuah perusahaan. Okay, I'm going to ask you, how about the providers, phone providers or internet providers? Phone provider ya, mostly ya. With the red colors dominant. Operator telepon dengan warna dominan merah apa?
Telkomsel.
Telkomsel. Seperti itu. Bentar ya. Okay, seperti itu. Pentingnya sebuah visi sebuah perusahaan itu dikomunikasikan. Jadi orang tahu begitu identitas dari provider warna merah itu adalah Telkomsel. Kuning?
Indosat.
Biru, hijau?
Pertama atau kurang.
XL, seperti itu ya. Okay. Vision statement, a future-oriented declaration of organization's purpose and aspirations. Addresses what a firm or organization wants to become. Vision statement tends to be relatively brief. Jadi visi itu singkat. Misalnya nih ya, cita-cita tadi mau jadi orang sukses itu visinya. Tapi misinya itu harus lebih panjang lagi. Sukses apa? Menjadi orang yang sukses lahir batin dunia akhirat kayak begitu. Bisa dimengerti?
Yes, Miss.
Oke, nanti kalian bisa baca sendiri ininya ya. Bisa? Tinggal dibaca saja, and then you can ask me questions if you want to me to explain more further about some PowerPoint. That's why before I start the class, I always share today's topic with you a day before. Jadi saya udah share kenapa supaya kalian bisa baca sendiri di rumah. Yeah, and then we can have a discussion. Kayak tadi, enak nggak kalian sharing your opinions?
Yes.
Dan biasanya kalian belajar lebih banyak dari diskusi seperti itu daripada kalian saya suruh ngapalin PowerPoint.
Berdiskusi.
Ya, makanya kalau berdiskusi salah satu syaratnya, Vika, kamu harus baca materi, tonton videonya a day before the class is started. Deal?
Deal.
Okay. Now I'm going to ask you about value. We already talk about the visions and missions. Yeah? How about values? Nilai-nilai. Kamu belum ada gambaran kan tentang nilai-nilai ini apa sih? Can you give me an example of value in your life?
Apa? I want to see something
okay,
about value.
Okay, boleh.
We say that value is a guide. Huh? So can we call knowledge as a value?
Boleh. Knowledge is one of your values. Jadi salah satu value kamu itu adalah knowledge. Knowledge will guide you to what to do and what you should achieve or something. Or for examples ya, you learn about, you have a knowledge about management principles. So you know you have to make a time schedule, ya kan? You know you have to make a clear vision. Harus punya visi yang jelas. Harus punya schedule. That's why you are in this classroom to learn about management principles. The basic of management. It's knowledge that you have to learn. You have to be master in management principle. Kenapa? Because this is the basic of management. Kamu harus ahli nih dalam management principle. Ini dasarnya manajemen kan? Right after you finish the lessons in management principles, this is the basic of management, and then you will trying a new types of management. Contohnya, kamu prodinya apa? Muhammad. Muhammad siapa ini? Muhammad siapa? Kamu tuh yang nanya barusan ngomong cuma Nadir Muhammadnya doang di sini. Muhammad Iqbal. Oke, Muhammad Iqbal, kamu prodinya apa?
Public relation.
Public relation. So you will come about the management of speaking di public relations. Yang akuntansi gimana? Manajemen akuntansi. Kan seperti itu. So you have to master in management principle, the basic of management, the knowledge of management. Seperti itu. Muhammad Iqbal. Ada lagi? Ini yang mau bertanya about values? Oke, Lutfi.
Tapi saya mau bertanya yang visi misi, mau nggak apa-apa?
Nggak apa-apa, boleh.
What happens if someone doesn't attach important to vision and mission because that person thinks that if you live, then just go with the flow?
Okay, when a person doesn't have a clear vision about one, what that person want to become in the future. Ya, gini, analoginya ya, you want to go out and then ride a bicycles or a motorcycles, or you riding a car, you driving, ya, the analogical of a person's without a clear visions and missions, ya, just go with the flow. When you ride a car, are you going to ride along the way, nyetir aja terus? Puputran, tahu-tahu, and then you realize, oh, saya di Sumatera, padahal my destination, tujuan saya adalah ke Jakarta. Betul nggak? That's the analogical if you didn't have a value, visions and missions. If you have a clear visions, you write your car and then your visions. Oh, I want to go to Jakarta. And then you will go along the way, but your way is going to lead you to Jakarta. That's missions. Missions itu you go along the way, and then your visions is go to Jakarta. Missionnya ngikutin nggak ke arah Jakarta? You're riding your car to Jakarta. Betul? So, yes, kalau kamu nggak punya visi sama misi, just circling around the streets, muter-muter di jalan, 10 tahun muterin jalan Bandung belum beres. Atau tiba-tiba kamu muter-muter jalan, tau-tau nyampe di Kalimantan. Ah, saya kan mau ke Jakarta, gitu. So, that's why I told you, you have to have a vision and missions. Because you have to have a goals, because it's going to lead you to fulfilling your dreams faster. Kenapa faster? Karena kamu tahu, you have a destination. Kalau kamu tahu kamu mau ke Jakarta ya, dari Bandung mau ke Jakarta, kira-kira apakah kamu harus lewat tol Palikanci, muter ke Jawa Timur baru ke Jakarta? Lutfi?
Yes, Miss.
Kalau kamu tahu mau ke Jakarta, you're riding your cars, ya, your visions is go to Jakarta. Tujuan kamu mau ke Jakarta. Missionsnya kan kamu harus naik mobil, ngikutin jalan ke Jakarta kan?
Yes.
Ya. Apakah kamu akan naik mobil muter dulu ke arah Garut baru ke Jakarta?
No.
No. What will you do? Kamu mau ngapain? Kalau kamu naik mobil dari Bandung ke Jakarta?
Mau lihat arah jalan.
Lihat arah jalan. Lihat guidance. Guidance is your value, ya. Value-nya kamu bakal mikir, oh ternyata kalau mau ke Jakarta paling gampang lewat misalnya jalan tol. Oh, kalau ke Jakarta lewat ini. Kamu nyari guidance kan, nyari panduan kan? Karena yes, kamu tahu tujuan kamu. Misi kamu jelas, kamu dari Bandung ke Jakarta. Jakarta itu adalah vision. Kayak gitu. Jadi kalau orang nggak punya tujuan, if a person didn't have a vision, and then that person will not achieve or fulfilling the dreams faster than a person with a vision and missions. Jadi orang yang nggak punya visi misi tidak bisa mencapai tujuannya lebih jelas, lebih cepat daripada orang yang punya visi misi. Because a person with visions and missions have a guidance, punya panduan how to fulfilling the dreams. Jadi kamu sudah terarah nih di sini, tinggal maju terus mencapai mimpi. Bisa dimengerti?
Yes.
Oke. Okay. Ada lagi? Tadi Gofar.
Yes.
Gofar sama Dina ya?
Yes, Miss.
Dina terus siapa? Fika. Oke, okay. Gofar, Dina, Fika. Gofar boleh?
Yeah, Miss. I want to ask. Tapi sebelumnya maaf ya, Bu. I will be speak mixed English and in Indonesian.
It's alright. At least you try to mix the language. Thank you.
Disneyland Health School. Dulu saya pernah belajar manajemen mengenai analisis SWOT. Nah, what is the what? What is relationship vision, mission, and with SWOT ini apa? Analisis, Bu. Jadi apa hubungan analisis SWOT dengan visi mission dan yang mana yang harus didahulukan, Bu?
Oke, okay. Thank you. It's a good question ya, Gofar ya. Vision, missions, and then SWOT analysis. Just like I ask you about your strength on and your weaknesses last week, ya kan? When you know about your strength and your weaknesses, and then you know you have a vision and missions, kamu tahu kelebihan kamu apa, and then you can achieve your goals, tujuan kamu. Kira-kira kalau kamu nggak punya visi misi, kemudian kamu tahu kelebihan dan kekurangan kamu, you didn't know what to do with your strength and your weaknesses. Betul nggak? But when you have a vision, mission, and you know the value of yourself by doing a SWOT analysis, by doing a self-assessment. Okay, I can do it. I can fulfill my dreams because I know I'm capable to do the job. Kamu tahu kamu mampu melakukannya karena kamu tahu kamu punya kelebihan. That's the relation between SWOT analysis and between the SWOT analysis and vision also missions. Bisa dimengerti? Jadi SWOT analysis is a tool for you to fulfilling your visions and missions faster, of course, because you know your value. Kamu tahu nilai kamu apa, kamu tahu kamu bisa mencapai mimpi kamu. You have a confidence. Kamu pede kan? Cipil itu mah tercapai. Pernah nggak begitu? Because you know the value of yourself. Kamu tahu, kamu mampu. Kamu punya kemampuan itu. How about the weakness? Weaknessnya gimana, Bu? Weakness. Kamu tahu kamu punya kelemahan, so you have to do something about your weaknesses. Kamu harus melakukan sesuatu before your weaknesses becoming your barriers, becoming ancaman, threat. You have to do something about this. Apa yang akan kamu lakukan? By using your strength, dengan mempertajam kekuatan kamu itu. You have to use your strength to overcome your weakness and the threat. Weakness sama ancaman. Bisa dimengerti? Kalau kamu mau nembak, kamu tahu sasarannya di sana. Misalnya manah aja ya. Kamu mau manah, kamu ada sasaran kan? Di depan, ada target. Ya kan? Terus kamu aiming kan? Kamu mengarahkan gini kan? Betul nggak? Kamu ngarahnya ke tujuan. Kamu tahu apa yang bisa kamu lakukan. Kamu tahu, you have the tools. kamu punya alatnya buat kamu panah ke arah sana, kamu punya misi yang harus kamu lakukan ngarah tepat ke sana. That's analogy for vision, missions, and SWOT analysis. Jadi kamu tahu ini jarak segini, kamu harus tarik busurnya sekian supaya bisa mencapai sekian dengan mengarahkannya ini, itu hubungannya. Bisa dimengerti, Govan? Atau masih bingung?
Jadi mana yang harus didahulukan ya, Bu, antara analisis SWOT dengan membuat si misi, yang mana harus didahulukan saat kita
yang didahulukan. Kira-kira menurut temannya, boleh kita share? Menurut teman kamu, ada yang bisa share? Apa duluan?
Analisis what, Miss?
Analisis what. Kenapa?
Karena analisis what itu mencakup opportunity, weakness, sama strength. Itu jadi kita bisa mengetahui apa kelemahan dari dalam diri kita dulu sebelum menentukan visi dan misi.
Okay, thank you, Peggy. Jadi gini, itu pendapatnya Peggy. Kalau pendapat saya, it depends on that person, ya. Tiap orang tuh punya pendapat yang berbeda-beda. For me, buat saya, I have to set goals. Saya harus set dulu tujuan. Ada target yang mau dicapai, benar nggak? Itu targetnya. That's my visions and these are the missions. Ini misinya tuh ada segini. Targetnya satu, becoming a successful person. Misinya tuh ada satu, graduated from LP3I and then get a proper job, maybe ya. Yeah? That's the missions. Tapi when you set your missions and then you will use everything that you have to fulfilling your visions. Kamu akan melakukan apapun untuk mencapai tujuan, bukan? Benar nggak? Jadi you will use everything that you have. Kemudian kamu menganalisa nih, apa yang saya punya? Kamu punya apa? Apa yang harus kamu lakukan untuk mencapai tujuan? Benar nggak? Seperti tadi analogi, dari Bandung mau ke Jakarta. Target kamu udah jelas, Jakarta. You want to go to Jakarta. Kemudian ke sana. Kemudian kamu lihat jarak yang harus saya tempuh, misalnya 120 km. Dengan beberapa titik pemberhentian. Ya. Jarak sekian, saya punya apa nih yang bisa saya pakai untuk ke arah sana? Apa itu yang saya punya? Itu SWOT analysis. Doing SWOT analysis, kan? Saya punya misalnya mobil. Oke, dengan mobil saya akan sampai ke Jakarta misalnya dalam waktu 1 jam. Oke, saya nggak punya mobil, saya punya motor. Dengan motor saya akan sampai ke Jakarta dalam waktu misalnya 5 jam. Nggak punya mobil, nggak punya motor, apa yang bisa saya lakukan? Oke, saya bisa naik travel. There are many ways. Banyak jalan to fulfilling your dreams. Ngerti? But the most important thing, you have to set a goal, vision. Kamu harus punya tujuan dulu. Itu for me ya, buat saya. But it's different. Maybe Peggy harus analisis dirinya dulu, kemudian baru dia sadar, oh ternyata saya memiliki kelebihan dalam bidang ini, artinya saya mau jadi ini. Ada yang begitu juga. Bisa dimengerti, Govan?
Yes, Miss, I understand.
Okay, thank you. Vika and Dina.
Yes, Miss.
Yes. Boleh, Vika?
Is it possible that the vision and mission can be different?
I'm going to share your questions to the floor. I'm going to open your questions to the floor. Saya akan buka di umum. Ada yang mau bantu jawab? Is it possible for missions and visions and missions to be different? Mungkin nggak? Ada yang boleh bantu jawab? Senjaya boleh? Is it possible for visions and missions to be different? Okay, Gofar, your answer is no. Nggak boleh dong, cuma no doang. Harus you have to explain to Vika. Kenapa your answer is no, Gofar?
Tadi pertanyaannya tuh mungkin nggak visi dan misi itu berbeda gitu, Bu?
Yes.
Gimana? Kalau menurut saya mah, gak bakal gitu, gak bakal mungkin berbeda. Soalnya kan sebelum kita menentukan misi, kita harus juga tahu akan visi itu gitu. Jadi misi itu hadir dan hasil dari hasil visi yang tadi gitu.
Bagaimana Fika?
Itu mungkin.
Terima kasih Mr. KM for sharing your thought with us. Bagaimana Fika? Ada lagi yang lain mungkin? Adit? Ada lagi yang lain? Boleh Nadila, silakan.
Kalau menurut Nabila itu nggak bisa beda karena kan visi itu tujuan dari diri seseorang gitu. Kalau misalkan S dengan misi adalah cara kita mencapai tujuan tersebut. Jadi kalau visi dan misinya berbeda, bagaimana caranya untuk mencapai tujuan tersebut gitu, Ibu.
Oke, thank you Nabila. Jadi seperti itu, Fika. You cannot have a different missions and visions. Tadi contohnya ya. But maybe your visions can be slightly different, sedikit beda itu mungkin. Misalnya, tadi saya bilang dari Bandung mau ke Jakarta kan? Visionnya Jakarta. Tapi there are many ways to go to Jakarta. Ada banyak cara kan? Cuman kalau misalnya kamu tujuannya ke Jakarta and then you go straight to Jawa Tengah, ke arah Jawa Tengah, kira-kira tercapai nggak, Fika? Nggak akan. Tapi, coba ya, tapi misalnya, you want to go to Jakarta. Slightly different itu misalnya gini, kamu mau ke Jakarta, tapi kamu mungkin ada perlu dulu belok dulu ke Sumedang. Dari Sumedang mungkin kamu masuk ke Kalijati, naik tol, pakai tol langsung ke Jakarta, kira-kira bisa nggak? Bisa. Tapi kalau totally different, nggak bisa. Kalau benar-benar berbeda, seperti tadi. Visinya ke Jakarta, tapi kamu misinya ke arah Surabaya. Nggak akan ketemu. Kecuali you go around the world, ya muter seluruh sedunia gitu, dari Bandung, muterin sedunia baru nyampe Jakarta, itu masih mungkin. Tapi kalau totally different itu nggak bisa. Kalau benar-benar berbeda ya, analoginya seperti itu. Bisa dimengerti?
Yes, Miss.
Okay, thank you. How about you, Dina? What is your questions?
Miss, sorry for webcam because my signal is bad. And does the
can you hear Dina's voice? Ada yang bisa dengar?
Cek. Halo.
Ya, gimana Dina?
Udah ada suaranya Bu?
Baru ini ada, yang tadi hilang.
Iya, keluar masuk Bu sinyalnya. Mohon maaf.
Gak apa-apa.
Okay, does the bankruptcy of a company occur because of its failure to carry out its vision and missions, Miss?
Ke perusahaan bisa gagal untuk mencapai visi misi.
Jadi apakah kebangkrutan dari suatu perusahaan itu karena ketidaksampaiannya mereka dalam mencapai visi dan misi? Seperti itu, Miss.
Okay, thank you, Dina, for your question. Usually, a company becoming a bankrupt not because their missions or visions, but mismanage, salah dalam pengelolaan. Pengelolaan apa? Bisa pengelolaan sumber daya uangnya, bisa pengelolaan, manajemen manusianya, bisa pengelolaan peralatannya. Jadi kemudian juga pengelolaan penjualannya, pengelolaan dan pengelolaan dalam segala managing in many ways. 6M, remember? We learn about management principles, how to manage 6M, man, money. Apalagi Dina? 6M?
Ya, Miss.
6M itu apa aja?
Sorry, Miss, putus-putus.
Man, money, money.
Ya.
Method, Miss.
Method, machine. Ya. Jadi salah mismanage dalam 6M itu. Makanya perusahaan bisa bangkrut. Bukan karena vision and missions. Tapi mungkin juga missionnya yang salah. Karena biasanya visions itu diangan-angan, bukan? Tujuan cita-cita budi yang luhur sekali, visionnya. Something's wrong with the visions. vision yang di breakdown menjadi mission, misinya yang ada yang salah dengan misinya. That's why in management we learn about planning, organizing, leading, actuating, and controlling. Apa controllingnya? You have to make sure that your company is in the right way, in the right path, according to the plan, sesuai dengan rencananya. Seperti itu, Dina.
Yes, Miss. Thank okay. you.
Thank you. You're ada welcome. Lagi yang mau ditanyakan? Ini apa ini?
Miss, maaf mau nanya, Miss.
Boleh.
Ini apa? Aku buka LMS, Miss, tapi kenapa di sini kehadirannya cuma ada satu, Miss? Cuma satu person.
Oh, benar, saya belum ngecek kehadiran kamu hari ini ya. Untung diingetin. Udah ngisi siakat belum?
Dari minggu kemarin, Miss, tapi cuma satu yang hadirnya. Di beberapa pelajaran juga ada yang kayak gitu.
Kalau minggu kemarin sama pelajaran lain mah ke akademik aja ya. The academic oh, iya. will make confirmations akan ke bentar. Nanti saya salah. Akademiknya akan konfirmasi nanti ke dosennya hadir atau enggaknya. Untung diingetin. Thank you. Input absensi. Meanwhile, why don't you open your LMS? Ada assignment tuh. Yang berikutnya about vision and mission. Adit?
Present.
Oke, okay. Agit sakit ya?
Iya, Miss.
Alia?
Present.
Amelia?
Present.
Amita?
Present, Miss.
Andi, Suhandi, Rasidi?
Present, Miss.
Oke. Okay. Hadiansyah, Ardiansyah? Ardinda? Daniel.
Yes, Miss.
Okay, thank you.
Miss.
Dina. Diva.
Yes, Miss.
Diva ada? Diva nggak ada?
Diva have a problem with
connection. Okay, nggak apa-apa. Farha?
Hadir, Miss.
Farha.
Yes,
Miss. Peggy. Fika. Fitri ada?
Sorry, Miss. Farhan hadir.
Oke, okay. Fitri ada?
Fitri pindah ke kelas, Miss. Pindah okay. ke karyawan.
Kaila?
Present, Miss.
Kurnia? Kurnia?
Kurnia tadi masuk, cuma keluar katanya, Miss.
Signal. Lutfi?
Present, Miss.
Lutfi ya? Nak? Maaf, Lutfiana ada? Lutfiana Hanifah Azizah? Nggak ada? Oke. Okay. M. Gofar? Ada dong, saya tahu. Muhammad Ivan Awaludin?
Present, Miss.
Muhammad Iqbal?
Present, Miss.
Muhammad Putra Rasidin?
Present, Miss.
Nabila Adaran? Nurul?
Present, Miss.
Nurul? Nursarika? Pia?
Present, Miss.
Present, Miss.
Puput.
Present, Miss.
Putri.
Present, Miss.
Rinaldi. Nggak ada. Ada kabar? No news? Oke.
No news, Rinaldi.
Reza.
Tadi present, Miss.
Rifki Naufal. Tadi ada. Risha.
Present, Miss.
Salsabila.
Present, Miss.
Senjaya.
Present.
Silvi.
Present, Miss.
Siti Rokaya.
Present, Miss.
Sumiati.
Present, Miss.
Widya.
Present, Miss.
Hilda.
I'm here.
Okay, thank you.
Present, Miss.
Okay, thank you. That's all. Asik, selesai. Alhamdulillah. Thank you for the reminder. Untuk pengingatnya, tadi siapa itu? Untung nanya. Saya lupa.
Rifki, Miss.
Oke, okay, Rifki. Ada lagi pertanyaan?
Jadi, Miss.
Ya. Masih mau nanya?
Bagian
kamu
akademiknya. Ya? Kalau yang bukan, kalau yang pelajaran, Miss, tinggal ke bagian akademiknya atau gimana?
Iya, kamu ke bagian akademik. Jadi, if you have some difficulties with academic, you can ask PIC of academic in your WhatsApp group. Ada PIC, person in charge dari akademik di grup kelas kamu.
Okay, Miss.
Bisa lapor. Makasih, Miss. Mumpung masih dalam waktu yang ini ya, masih baru 4 pertemuan. Nanti dari akademik akan berkonfirmasi dengan dosen yang bersangkutan. Atau kamu bisa mungkin, maaf Bapak, Ibu boleh menuliskan konfirmasi bahwa saya memang hadir dari perkuliahan pertama sampai keempat. Nanti kamu capture, kemudian kirimkan ke pihak akademik, sekalian kamu lapor bahwa kamu memang hadir.
Okay, Miss. Okay. Thank you.
Gak mau nanya kuliah saya? Udah ngerti?
Insyaallah.
Okay, I'm going to ask you. How about your conclusions for today's lesson? Conclusionsnya apa?
Kesimpulan?
Ya, tentunya.
I think we have to a clear vision and mission for the future. Mm-hmm. If we want to grow up and to be success, and this is why we learn about weakness or strength from before pertemuan apa sih?
Blank. Tiga.
Before
this meeting ya, last week ya.
Yes, yes.
Oke, okay, thank you. Yes. Ternyata kamu menyimak. Oke. Okay. Sepertinya sudah cukup pertemuan hari ini sampai di sini. If you have any questions, you can ask me next week ya. Kita, kamu can, you can save your questions. Mudah-mudahan kamu masih ingat. You can write down your questions, and then I'm going to answer your questions next week. Okay? Okay aja. Dan sekarang udah siang, aku udah lapar. Mr. Gofar, tolong ditutup kelasnya.
Okay, thank you both. Please attention, guys. Of the lesson, let's break it up. Right, smart.